Hey everyone, thanks for watching. Today I'm going to be doing a makeup tutorial. Last night in Toronto was the Much Music Video Awards, and kind of today on TV there was a lot of recaps on various networks, basically what happened last night. And I saw this look that Gigi Hadid was rocking, and I think it's so classic and tasteful, fun, flirty, and super duper simple and age appropriate. So yeah, she seems like she's a really nice chick, and hopefully you guys really enjoy this look, and let's get started. So to start off, I'm using my Rimmel Wake Me Up Foundation and 303 True Nude and my Real Techniques Multitask Brush. And I'm using the smallest amount of foundation because she's so young. She doesn't need a lot of foundation, and it's quite evident in the pictures that she's wearing a very sheer-like foundation. So I really just used a little bit and made sure I blended it in seamlessly with my skin. Taking MAC Soft Brown and a big fluffy brush, I am using this neutral toned color as my transition and blending color, and you really just want to take your time and blend this color through your crease. This color really helps to give that soft, diffused look. Next, I'll be using a product similar to the Stila like liquid. I don't know how to explain it, but it's for the foil eyeshadows. The one I'm using is Annabelle, and then this eyeshadow I put in a MAC container, but it's Makeup Geek's Magic Act. And you just place a little drop on the back of your hand, dampen your brush slightly. And what's really cool about this product is it enhances foil shadow. So this is a foil shadow by Makeup Geek. And I recommend that you use it as close to the edge as possible, because the liquid can sometimes make your your eyeshadows kind of like weird kind of textures. And then you just want to apply this just to your lid area and almost in a cut crease kind of fashion. Like, you don't want it going into your crease at all. You want to keep the color just consistently on the lid. And then taking the same fluffy brush as before, I'm just now softly blending everything together so it's a smooth transition in the crease from the lid. Using my Smashbox Double Exposure and a taper crease brush, I'm taking this maroony plummy color very lightly, and I'm concentrating it only in my crease bone and on the outer corner. And then once you've put the color there, you go back in with that same fluffy brush and you blend everything out, so again, so it looks really soft and diffused and blended. No, it don't mean a thing if I ain't in your eyes, but it ain't gonna fly. Next, I'm taking this Kiko palette in 02 Addictive Song and this dark brown shimmery shadow and a flat brush, and I'm applying it just to the tip of the brush and then basically running it on my lower lash line in a diffused manner, again to keep it very soft but also add that definition. Using a brown gel eyeliner to kind of give that not so harsh look with the black, I'm doing the thinnest line of eyeliner on the top of my eyelid with what I like to call like a little kitten flick, just to give a tiny bit of your eye that lift, but still nothing too dramatic, again keeping it really soft and natural looking. Then using MAC's Kohl Pencil and Teddy, I am using it very deliberately and putting it all over my lower lash line and in my waterline as well, again to add a little bit more definition. Then I'm taking MAC's Nylon eyeshadow and a very small brush, and I'm using this to highlight my inner corner very deliberately. Then I'm taking my Physician Formula Mascara and Fiber Boost, and I'm putting three coats on. And here I'm just going to show it once. So what I usually do is I first put on a coat of mascara, and then once I've done that and I do it quite deliberately, I then take the wand with the fibers and I add it to the tip to really give me that length so you don't need fake eyelashes. I'm taking my Bourjois concealer in 52. I am then lightly dabbing it to conceal any dark circles that I might have. She's young, so she probably doesn't need a lot. And then also I'm using it to help clean up the lines and that outside, just to give it a little bit more sharp and cleaner look. Taking my Maybelline Fit Me powder and 230 Natural Buff and a Real Techniques. I think that is the deluxe. No, that is the, I forget what it's called now, contour brush. I'm using it literally to seal my my concealer, my foundation, and I'm just basically applying it all over my face. And from there, I then am taking my Bourjois bronzer in 52 and a big fluffy brush, and I'm lightly dusting it along the top of my hairline. She doesn't look like she's wearing a lot of bronzer. And then I'm putting it on the tops of my cheeks where I'm going to add blush. This is my favorite blush, which is MAC Peaches. And again, I'm using that same fluffy brush and I'm lightly dusting it on the apples and extending it towards the back of my hairline. So give it that kind of California look, I guess, with the bronzer and the peach blush. Then this is what really makes the look, is she has a lot of highlighter on. This is the Benefits What's Up highlighter, and I'm being quite deliberate with it. I think I put it on twice because she has such highlighted and dewy cheekbones, and then I'm just using my fingers to really blend this into the skin. Next, using MAC's Sandy B lipstick. I look really weird when I put lipstick on. I don't like watching myself. Just apply your lipstick. Next, put a champagne lip gloss over top. This one's by Gosh, and I'm just putting it on the center of my lips. So this is my finished Gigi Hadid inspired look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. As always, I hope you have a fantastic day, whatever you're doing. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment below. Thanks for watching. Bye.